first video of 2022 is a replay provided by Lee Schwarren, and it is a replay of the Panzer 5-4. Now, for you guys who are new around here, you don't know about this tank. This is the Panzer 5-4 that was a reward tank for the alpha players or the early players of World of Tanks. This was like back in 2010 for those of you guys in EU, and for the guys in Asia and NA probably around 2012 or something like that. Anyway, this tank is a very rare tank. You need to be like a really OG old timer to get this tank for free. But in 2019, this tank did make its debut on the black market for the first time ever. No one expected it to be on sale on the black market, but it did come on sale, and it was for 5,500 gold. It did not appear again in 2020 and 2021. Black market is coming up sometime soon, maybe in a month or two, I suppose. And this tank could make its comeback again as, like, you know, kind of like a surprise. So don't be surprised if this does show up. The Panzer 5-4, well, the reason why you're seeing it is because this tank is completely OP tank. This tank is a seal clubber. This tank is really competitive. Well, I won't say really competitive, really overpowered for its class in tier 5. We'll go through the stats a little bit and we'll talk about this tank today, and you should prepare. Why you should prepare for this tank in case it does show up again for the black market sales. Like I was mentioning, this tank is really powerful. Our friend Lee Schwarren here is running this tank with hardening, vents, and a rammer. Now, if you take a look at the stats, this tank reloads in 3.64 seconds. Not exactly a tank that is a candidate for a gun rammer, because a gun rammer would only reduce the reload time 10%, so it would bring the reload down to 3.3 seconds instead of the 3.6 seconds. It doesn't make a lot of difference, 0.3 of a second. So if this was my tank, I wouldn't run a gun rammer on it. But I'm not going to tell you how to run your tank. You run it any way you like. If you think 0.3 seconds is worthwhile for you, especially in a fight like this where your reload is going to be important, I suppose it makes sense to run a gun rammer in this kind of situation. But anyway, let's take a look at this tank again. 110 damage with 110 penetration. This tank has also 158 penetration if you fire the premium shells, which is APCR. The shell velocity on the standard shells, 790 meters per second, not like the quickest, not the highest velocity, but it is playable. The APCR premium shells is about 988 meters per second shell velocity, not that bad at all, but not the greatest. But for tier 5, it is absolutely amazing. In fact, it makes this tank very competitive even when it's playing against tier 6 tanks. This tank has a 0.35 dispersion, or maybe we should go on with the horsepower first. We'll talk about the horsepower. 740 horsepower, very good power to weight ratio, 18.73. You can see this tank has the agility of a light tank. It has 55 kilometers an hour going forward, 20 kilometers an hour speed going backwards, rotation 39 degrees per second. 39 degrees per second. It is a really fast, agile tank. The turret armor, however, isn't great. The hull armor is very good for a tier 5, 85mm frontally, 40mm on the side. You can side scrape with this tank. However, the weak spot is in the turret, only 50mm on the front of the turret. In order to fight this tank, you actually need to shoot this tank straight into the turret. Again, damage on this tank, only 110 damage, but you can fire every 3.5 seconds. So that is why this tank is very competitive. The penetration on the standard shells, 110, is not that great, but with premium shells, you are good to go. You can fight almost anything. The dispersion 0.35 is not that great, which is why if I was running this tank, I'd probably remove that gun rammer and put in an improved aim instead of a gun rammer. That would bring my dispersion down to probably 0.33, 0.32, which would make this gun absolutely fantastic. The moving dispersion is pretty good on this gun, 0.12. The aim time as well, 1.92 seconds, makes this tank highly competitive. Really fast firing, great combat tank. This is a medium tank that can really play like a heavy tank. It can play in the front lines. It can be hyper aggressive, which makes this tank really great. Now, the gun depression, it says here 10 degrees of gun depression and 20 degrees of gun elevation. In all reality, this tank frontally only has 8 degrees of gun depression. A lot of tanks work this way. It says 10 degrees of gun depression, but you don't really have 10 degrees, you only have 8 degrees frontally. But if your tank is pointing towards the side of the tank, that's when you will get the full 10 degrees. Like right now in this position, you have 10 degrees of gun depression. But right over the front of the tank, you only have 8 degrees. So that is where you can say it is a bit of, you know, you get kind of like fooled into believing that it has 10 degrees, but in actual fact, in actual practice, it does not have a full 10 degrees. Look at our friend here, tier 5 gain already racked up 2900 damage, already reaching 3000 damage. He's gonna get a lot more damage in this game. Like I said, even though this is a very aggressive, very good tank, if you want to hit the jackpot numbers, if you want to do 4000 damage in this tank, you need to bide your time, you need to play carefully, you need to you know, not be too rash, not to throw your hit points away. Play like our friend, be careful, plot your journey. When you are playing against tier 5 tanks, you are coming up against three kinds of players. One, you are fighting against new players, absolute noobs, and you can completely farm them, take advantage of them, do a lot of damage on them, and basically treat them as piñatas, and you can totally farm them out, farm those enemies out. Number two, you could be dealing with other SEAL clubbers, other good players that are also playing low tier tanks and trying to boost their win rate, or trying to boost their WN8 or whatever. You get a lot of different kind of players in this game. You can't stop them. It's gonna happen. You're going to face them. You just have to accept it. So you're gonna deal with noobs, you're gonna deal with other SEAL clubbers, and you know, you got to be prepared for that. Sometimes you are also dealing with players that just have no idea what they're doing. Maybe they're noobs, but they're aggressive noobs. Those guys that YOLO out in the front and just rush in to try and do damage on you. They try to kill you. They try to harakiri. They try to seppuku. You know, they know they're gonna die, but they want to take you with them. You get these kinds of players as well. So when you are playing in low tiers, it's not just a easy free ride. You do need to have a little bit of low tier mentality, I would say. When you want to play in low tiers, you have to be wary of these kinds of players. the new players that you can absolutely farm for free sit at the same spot, just accept the blind shots that our friend is firing at them and take them for their full HP. Those new players, other seal clubbers that are as good as you, if not better than you, or some new players that just want to YOLO and, you know, destroy you. They try to wreck you. They don't care if they get themselves killed. But, you know, you deal with them and, you know, you move on. But if you're doing it in a tank like this, the PZ-54 reward tank, it makes your job a lot easier. It makes your seal clubbing session, your farming session, your WN8 padding session, it just makes it a lot better. Now, if you pay attention to the damage that he's doing, it looks like it's a 3,000 plus damage, but remember, he's got a little bit of blind shot damage when he was shooting the sniper's nest in Kilo 5 as well, and that is going to be reflected in the results. Obviously, this is going to be an ace tanker game, a bunch of medals as well. 4,212 damage in a tier 5 tank. If you did 4,212 damage in a tier 10 tank, you would be quite proud of yourself and you would be quite happy. But to do it in a tier 5 tank, it is very possible, especially in a tier 5 Panzer 5-4. So remember, prepare yourself for at least 5,500 gold if this tank ever shows up again in the black market, which probably is in about 1 or 2 months time. Thanks for watching this video. I'll see you on the next one. Bye bye.